Hey guys, Applejew here with a long overdue Overwatch YouTube video. I apologize for not putting out more videos since the last one I had put out, and it's mostly because I've been doing a lot of streaming. I've been doing a lot of PUBG and games and all sorts of other stuff, and I've been kind of neglecting my YouTube channel, unfortunately. So with that, I thought that today's video would be a fun one to do about a topic that I feel like I know a decent amount about. And that's the idea of confidence, of practice, of being able to do things without thinking about them, and how habits tie all these things together. So, what do I mean by confidence? So, confidence would be you get into a game of Overwatch and you're confident that you can, aim relatively well, and that you can move around the map effortlessly. Oftentimes, people who lack confidence are unwilling to even play the game. I mean, I have some friends that I would love to play with, but because they feel like they are not good at the game, because they feel like they're not at the level that I'm at, that they don't want to play, which makes me sad because I don't care if they're good or not. I just like to play with my friends. So, yeah, confidence is extremely important when playing Overwatch. The other thing is the idea of practice. A lot of YouTubers like talking about practice. So, what do I mean by that? There's the practice range. I've seen streamers like Seagull and several others that literally will spend a good 15, 20, 30 minutes in the practice range just perfecting their flick shots or their head shots or whatever. And I mean, it's really good practice. I mean, if everyone did it, they would probably improve somewhat in their mechanical abilities. But there's also good practice and there's bad practice. And I'll explain what that means when I get into the idea of habits. So, good practice would be playing a game like Overwatch, to win. So, if you go into every game with the motivation to win, go into every fight with the motivation to win that fight, or to at least minimize your losses. So, not necessarily going into a fight to win it, but if you go into a fight and you're obviously losing it, trying to minimize your losses. So making sure you don't get staggered, or making sure that your supports get out alive, maybe protect that Mercy and try and get that res off or something like that. So that would be like something that would be good that somebody would do to practice. You have bad practice. So bad practice, the number one that comes to my head is when you play with a bad Reinhardt, for instance. A bad Reinhardt usually is a Reinhardt that charges in YOLO Leroy Jenkins style way too often, and you see all the supports try and dive on him to keep him alive, and then suddenly you have a dead Reinhardt and you have a dead Mercy, and all of a sudden it's a 4v6 and you guys don't have a shield to hide behind anymore. That would be an idea of a bad practice, and oftentimes it is something that just doesn't get fixed, whether it's because it's a mental block, they don't think they're doing anything wrong, they don't see the fault in what they're doing. A lot of people do not take kindly to any kind of criticism, and the average internet person probably is not very good at giving constructive criticism, to be honest. Seems like when most people give criticism on the internet, they just insult you and they expect that you're gonna learn from that for some reason. I don't know. So yeah, that would be an idea of a bad practice. Now, this all honestly, everything ties down into something we all know, the idea of habits. You have good habits and you have bad habits. What something I think a lot of people do not realize is that there are a lot of good habits and a lot of bad habits that we may not even realize that we have. So some examples of habits that people don't necessarily think they have. Walking or running is a habit. When you first learn to run or walk, it was not a habit. It was hard. You had to think about every step you made. Now, obviously, we were very small children when that was happening, so it's not like it's something we can remember. So here's another really good example. Driving a car. Driving a car, for any of you who are 16 and older and have gotten your driver's license, driving a car when you first start doing it is terrifying. The very first time you get behind the wheel, and it doesn't matter how many times you've watched other people drive, it doesn't matter how many times you've thought about it, till you actually get in that car, put your hands on the wheel, and feel what it feels like to step on the gas, step on the brakes, it's nerve-wracking, and it takes a lot of practice. There's a reason why, in order to get your driver's license, you have to practice a certain number of hours before they're willing to give you a driver's license. And that's because that's where practice comes in. You have to practice something in order for it to become a habit. And with driving, as is with Overwatch, you can develop bad habits. So some examples of bad habits in driving: you don't use your blinkers, you don't wear your seatbelt, you don't check your mirrors, you don't adjust your mirrors, you don't adjust your seat, you don't properly look over your shoulders to check your blind spots. These are all examples of bad habits. And then you have good habits, like putting your hands at 10 and 2, or you know, always paying attention to the road and not looking at your cell phone, or any number of things like that, or even more simple things like you have a good habit of not tailgating people, which puts you at a higher risk of, you know, rear-ending somebody. So these are some really similar examples to what can happen in Overwatch. You can develop some very bad habits, like the Reinhardt charge. As a Zenyatta main, an example I can give you is whenever I got flanked by a Genji or a Tracer, my initial reaction and what became a habit that I ended up having to break is I would tend to fall back into my spawn area, or towards my spawn, which also meant that I was falling away from my team. And as a Zenyatta, if you don't have eyesight on your team, you're not healing your team. And if you're not healing your team, suddenly this one Tracer or this one Genji has pulled the supports away from the fight. Now it's a 4v5 on the other side, and they don't have any healers. And generally speaking, when that happens, it's a team wipe. Everyone's going to die. It's going to feel really bad. And the worst case scenario is you're going to end up getting staggered because the supports will die first, and then, you know, maybe 30 seconds later, the tanks and the DPS will die, and suddenly we're stuck in spawn for another minute or two waiting for everyone to spawn back in so we can group up and jump the point. So that's an example of a bad habit that I had, that took a conscious effort to overcome and replace. I replaced that habit with, instead of running back to my spawn to get away from the flanker, I would run towards my team. So I would run towards the backside of my D.Va, or the backside of my Reinhardt, or the backside of my Winston. And that way I could stay in the fight. It made me more vulnerable, obviously, because now I'm closer to the DPS, I'm closer to the tanks, but at least I'm able to heal, and at least my tanks have a chance to potentially deal with the flankers. So these are some ideas of habits that we have in Overwatch and in life. Something I've realized, a lot of these videos are probably going to have a dichotomy between real life and video games. A lot of these things pertain to both. Now, if I were starting an esports team, and I had the chance, I could choose from either seasoned veterans who have some really good habits and also may have some bad habits, or if I could choose a team of people who are maybe just, they're good at first person shooters, but they've never played Overwatch before, I would take the newbies every single time, because there's a very accepted theory that it is easier to build a new habit, a new good habit, than it is to try and replace or remove a bad habit. Bad habits are insanely hard to overcome. Just ask anyone who has had to quit smoking, chewing their nails, picking their nose, any of those weird bad habits that we may have developed are extremely hard to overcome. And in regards to cigarettes, there's also chemicals going on there that make it even harder for you to quit. So whereas it's easier if I have a newborn into the world and be like, just making sure that they don't ever develop a bad habit like chewing their nails or like picking their nose or like smoking cigarettes. You know, it's easier to stop somebody from becoming habitual than it is to replace a pre-existing habit. That's kind of what I wanted to talk about in this. I think people need to be a little bit more mindful of the habits that they have. You know, just the fact of the habit of putting my hand on my keyboard where the WASD keys are is so habitual, but most of us FPSers never realize it until we go and hang out with a person who's never played an FPS game before, who are like staring at their fingers, like trying to figure out what goes left, which goes right, what goes forward and what goes backwards. And seeing them trip over, you know, hitting the E key and they're accidentally hitting the R key, or they're hitting the one key instead of the Q key or something like that. It you don't realize that you've developed some pretty amazing habits that you don't ever even think about that when you're playing a game like this, because you've played hours upon hours upon thousands of hours of these video games. So, let me know, guys. What do you think of the idea of habits? Have you consciously thought about any good habits you have? Have you consciously thought about any bad habits that you have? Have you ever, or do you think that's a bunch of baloney and that, it's either you're good, you're talented, or you're not? I've heard that argument. I've heard, this person is just born to be a very good first person shooter player. So let me know. Let me know in the comments below. I hope you like this video. As you can see, I've got this new big Blue Yeti microphone here that looks nice and cool. And I hope it makes my voice sound a lot better than it did before. I was using some cheesy inline microphone with my headphones before. So this should sound considerably better than what I was using before. Anyway, I hope you guys have an amazing rest of your weekend and an amazing start to your next week. Again, let me know if there's anything you'd like to hear me talk about, or if there's anything you'd like me to add. I am all about doing videos based on conversations I might have with my friends or my other streamers that I hang out with and things like that. I like the idea of starting conversations and then making videos about them. Again, if you like this video, hit that like button below. If you want to keep seeing more content from me, hit that subscribe button. And if you ever want to check me out live where I play anything from Overwatch to PUBG to Stardew Valley, go to my Twitch, which should be linked below as well. Anyway, guys, I hope you have a great one. And remember, life's too short to be salty, so just don't do it.